Let's look at 5.3b. We're going to talk more about matrices. So we have two different kinds of forms when we reduce the matrix. So we have row echelon form and row reduced echelon form. Okay, so for row echelon form, any row consisting entirely of zeros occur at the bottom. For each row that does not consist entirely of zeros, the first non-zero entry is one, called the leading one. For two successive non-zero rows, the leading one is higher row, in the higher row is further to the left than the next one. Okay, so it looks like this. We have diagonals going like that. And then we have numbers here. So for row echelon, this is our goal, okay? You can have any number in these other spots, but our goal is to have these ones here and a triangle of zeros here, okay? So this is our goal for row echelon. And what it does is it helps us solve for the unknowns. So we would look at the bottom one, and that would tell us that z equals some number. Then we would plug it in here to find y. Then we would plug in both of these into this equation to solve for x, okay? The reduced row echelon form is where every column that has a leading one has zeros in the position above and below its leading. So it looks like this. It's also the diagonal. And then it has zeros in these spots. And then it has zeros here. And then numbers in that last spot. And then the reason this is important is we want x, y, and z as our answers. So whenever it has diagonal ones and the rest in this little square are zeros, this tells us what x, y, and z is. And this is always the same. But with our row echelon form, it may not be the same. You may have some different numbers in here, but it's not, it can be different because these can be any constant. Okay. Not all of these guys. This one will definitely be the same constant. All right. So let's look at the first example. So let's see, what are instructions? It says write the matrix in row echelon form. Remember that row echelon form of matrix is not unique. All right, so what we want to do is we want to perform operations on this matrix using row operations in order to get it in row echelon form. Okay, so we could, this is good. This row is solid because it has one. Okay, this row, we need to get rid of the three. So I'm going to multiply this one is really helpful. I can multiply it times negative 3 and then add it to row 2. So negative 3 times row 1 plus row 2 is going to give me my new row 2. So it's going to be negative 3, negative 6, 3, and negative 9. Then my row 2, just rewrite that. And add 0, 1, negative 2, 5. All right, so that's great. Now we have a 0, 1, which is our goal. Okay, so we also need to do something with row 2. So we are going to multiply row 1 by 2, not negative 2, because this is a negative 2, so we want the opposite. So I'm going to do 2 times row 1 plus row 2, no, row 3. To give us the new row 3. So I have 2, 4, negative 2, 6, and then negative 2, negative 1, negative 3, and 8. So 0, 3, negative 5, and 14. So our new matrix, I'm going to keep my same row 1. Row 2 is a 0, 1, negative 2, 5. So that's already in row echelon form. So what do we need to do with row 3 to get a 0 on that 3 spot? We're going to use now row 2 because this 0 is going to help us and this 1 is going to help us. So we are going to multiply row 2 times negative 3 times row 2. And I'm going to add it to the row 3 for my new row 3. So 0, negative 3, 6, negative 15. That's three, negative 3 times row 2. Sorry about that. That should be a row 2. And then rewrite row 3. Okay. Add those up. 0, 0, 1, negative 1. Oop, that's great. So now we're going to write row 1 is good. Row 2 is good. Row 3 is good. Oh, that's a 1. Negative 1. There we go. All right, that is what we want. This is called row echelon form. It has our diagonal of ones, and then it has this triangle of zeros, which gives us row echelon form. And then remember, these can be any number. So now we are going to use row echelon form and back substitution. The method of elimination can be applied to a system of linear equations in more than one, two variables. When elimination is used to solve a system, the goal is to rewrite the system in the form to which back substitution can be applied. Look at these two. Okay, so we have a system of equations. So I'm going to go ahead and write the system in matrix form. So this is one. Okay, so I filled in one, so it would be a little bit easier to write. Okay. Okay. And then after row operations were done, then this is the row echelon form. So it has a 0x plus 0x plus 0y plus z equals. So this as a matrix looks like this. 1, negative 2, 3, 9. 0, 1, 4, 7. 0, 0, 1, 2. Okay, and what this tells us is, let me get a different color. This tells me that z equals 2. Okay, so I'm going to use that to help do some back substitution. So z equals 2. So it says the second system is said to be in row echelon form, stair-step pattern with leading coefficients of 1. Process of converting a system to one that is in row echelon form requires using elementary row operations called Gaussian elimination. Okay, so we have z equals 2, and then our next equation is 1y plus 4z equals 7. So we use that to find out what y is. So y plus 4 times 2 equals 7. Well, that's 8, so we're going to subtract 8 from both sides, and I get y equals negative 1. All right, so I have z, I have y. Now I need to do x. So I use that very first equation. 1x minus 2y plus 3z equals 9. So x minus 2 times negative 1 plus 3 times z is 2 equals 9. So x plus 2 plus 6 equals 9. So this adds up to be 8. So I'm going to subtract 8 on both sides. X equals 1. So now I have an x, y, z, and I write my solution as such. X, y, z. X, y, and z. So that is my solution. All right. So let's look at Gaussian elimination with back substitution. So use Gaussian elimination to solve the system of equations. Use the matrix version of Gaussian elimination. The basic difference between two methods is that the matrix you do not need The matrices you do not need to keep writing with the variables. So that's what's helpful about that. We can use elimination, but this is a lot more helpful. All right, so let's see. Row one is good because remember we want that leading one. Row two is not good, but look at that. That's gonna give me zero. So I'm gonna add row one plus row two to give me the new row two. All right, so I'm gonna rewrite. So I'm gonna put an arrow, keep the same. I'm going to take out these. That just means that it equals. All right, so I add them. So 0, 1, 4, 7. Awesome. Okay. I need to do something to get the second equation to have a zero here. So then there's more than one way to do this. I think I'm going to do negative 2 times this first one. So negative 2 times row 1 plus the row 3 to give me my new row 3. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and multiply these here. So it'd be negative 2, 4, negative 6, negative 18. And then here's row 3. Add those up. 0, negative 1. -1. All right. So then I need to get this guy to be a zero. So it looks like I can use row two. So I'm going to, and they're already opposites. So I'm going to do row two plus row three to give me my new row three. So zero. I guess I can go ahead and write that down. Let's see. 0, 1, 4, 7. I'm just going to do this just so I can see it. 0, 0, 3, 6. Okay. I'm almost there. I'm going to go ahead and do one last thing because I want this to be a 1. So I'm going to do 1/3 times row 3 to give me my new row 3. So basically I'm dividing it by 3. So here, row 1 and row 2 are fine. Oh, I don't like how that looks. There we go. 0, 1, 4, 7. 0, 1/3 would be 1. 1/3 of 6 is 2. All right. So isn't this the same thing? Is it the same as this? Up here. 1, -2, 3, 9, 0, 1, 4, 7, 0, 0, 1, 2. It's the same thing. So I was able to show you how you went from this over to this, and then we did back substitution, which I showed you that, and that's how we were able to get X, Y, Z. Use back substitution above. To solve. So we still have the same thing. 1, -1, 2. All right, so let's look at our matrices here. It says write the solution or write the system of linear equations represented by the augmented matrix, then use back substitution to find the solution. Use variables x, y, and z when applicable. There we go. So x minus 2y equals 4, y equals negative 3. So we already have y, so now we plug it in. X minus 2 times negative 3 equals 4. X plus 6 equals 4. Minus 6 minus 6, x equals negative 2. So we're able to get x and y. Make sure you put it in the form of x and y. Negative 2, 3. So this is x and y. All right, the next thing, remember this is x, y, z. So I'm going to write x minus y plus 4z equals 0. y minus z equals 2, and z equals negative 2. All right, so we have this one. Now we're going to use the y minus z, so minus a negative is going to be plus 2 equals 2. So that's going to give me y equals 0. So I have y and z. So now I use the first equation, x minus y plus 4 times z equals 0. So x, that's going to be 0, so minus 8 equals 0. So x equals 8. So we have 8, 0, negative 2. X, y, and z. All right. Let's go to the next one. This just says x and y. So x plus 0, y equals 7, or just x equals 7. 0x plus 1y equals negative 5. So y equals negative 5. Super easy. Nothing you have to back substitute. That's all. Okay, the next one. Same exact thing. X, y, and z. So x equals negative 4. Y equals negative 8. Z equals 2. So we write it in parentheses. All right, so now we are going to get to using our calculator to solve the system. So we are going to convert this system into a matrix. So this would be 1, 2, 7, 2, 1, 8. Okay, so we are going to follow the steps. So for the graphing calculator, we are going to, you may have learned it a different way. I'm going to show you this way using one of the menus in Alpha. So here are the instructions. You do second matrix, which is the inverse. The little button is x to the negative 1. Then you go over to math. Then you go down to B, which is RREF, which remember RREF stands for row reduced echelon form. Okay, then it pops up this RREF and a parentheses. So then you do the hidden menu, alpha, zoom, and pick your matrix size. So 2 by 3 for the first one, or it could be 3 by 4 or something else. So I'm going to show you that. So let's go to our calculator. So we're going to follow the steps. Second matrix, over to math. Go up or down to get to B, RREF. Make sure you don't pick REF. Pick RREF. Then hit alpha zoom. And we've got to change this to a 2. Oh, hold on. Second matrix over to math. Alpha zoom. 2 by 3. Then hit OK. So I'm going to put in the coefficients or the entries of the matrix. So 1, 2, 7, 2, 1, 8, 1, 2, 7, 2, 1, 8, push enter. And that is our output matrix, which is in our row reduced echelon form. You have zeros in the diagonal, and then, I mean, ones in the diagonal, and then zero triangle down here and zero up there. And that gives us our solution. So what I'm going to have you do is write your solution in that matrix. 1, 0, 3, 0, 1, 2. That's what we got, right? Yep, 3, 2. So that tells me x equals 3, y equals 2. So we can write our solution as 3, 2. Okay, go ahead and do the next one. I'm going to go ahead and fill in 1s anywhere that there's not a coefficient. So we're going to do the REF. This is a little different. It has 1, 2, 3 rows by 4 columns. So 1, negative 2, 3, 9. Negative 1, 3, 1, negative 2, 2, negative 5, 5, and 17. And then it's going to come output matrix. That will give us our solution. So let's go ahead and put this in. So follow the same steps. Second matrix over to math. Then go to B, which is REF. Alpha, zoom. This time it's a 3 by 4. Now put our entries in. 1, negative 2, 3, 9. Negative 1, 3, 1, negative 2. 2, negative 5, 5, 17. Make sure I put it all in correctly. All right, Shinner. All right, so that is our solution. So let's go ahead and write that. It is 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, -1, 0, 0, 1, 2. So that tells me this is X, this is Y, this is Z. So I can write it as X, Y, Z. All right, so example 3 and 4 are going to be what you do on your own for the rest of this ed puzzle.